What are you doing?
Thought I'd try killing the bugs one at a time.
Well, I guess that's better than pesticides.
No, your husband wanted me to take a look at this. He says he's gonna use it this weekend.
Oh, yeah, he's going diving.
It does have a little hitch in the trigger here.
Listen, I made this. It's a tomato leaf vaporizer.
Tomato? Oh, the bugs are gonna love this. I'm telling you, unless you let me use some kind of chemical product, the war's lost. That's like attacking a panzer division with stones and sticks.
Well, we'll see. Oh, how did it go?
How'd what go?
The girl.
Oh, she called me and she asked me on a date.
And?
And nothing, I hung up on her.
You hung up?
Yeah, it's a matter of protocol. After I hung up, I called her back, I asked her out on a date.
You're such an old-fashioned idiot.
We're gonna go in the city. We're gonna see a play, and then I'm gonna take her dancing.
Dancing?
Yeah. I'm a very good dancer.
What kind of dancing?
All of them. Samba, rumba, salsa, swing, cha-cha.
Show me.
Do you know any ballroom dancing?
None.
All right, basic rumba box step. On one, you step back with your right foot and then just follow me, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And one, two, three, four, good. Oh, and I wanted to ask you if I could switch days, come in tomorrow instead of Friday, all right?
Oh, yeah, of course.
There you go, there you go. That's very good, you're a natural.
More?
No, I got a lot to do today. I gotta climb up on the roof and clean the skylights. That's enough, that's a good first lesson. Okay.
Try it.
What a waste of time.
Afternoon, Carl.
How you doing, Mr. Dudek?
Great. How's your day going?
Pretty good. Thank you.
Do you know if Sylvia's in the house?
Yeah, she's around the back.
In the garden?
Right, yeah.
Thanks, Carl.
Today was a great day. Extremely productive. How was yours?
Oh, much more productive than yours. Bella was wonderful.
Bella, did you spend the whole day reading?
Maybe. I made some phone calls also and set up meetings with potential investors.
Ooh, congrats.
What time are they gonna get here?
I told John 6, so most likely 7.
Have you met her yet?
No. But you know Sean's type. I'm sure she's very young.
Yes, of course. They all are. Jealous.
Me? Of course not. What is there to be jealous of?
I don't know. Sean and all his little tarts.
Tarts? Well, I got me the sweetest tart of them all. Sean's one who should be jealous.
Okay.
Oh, I need to take a shower.
I'll make my cocktail for everyone.
Please.
get up on your own two feet. When you're close to where there's food to eat. Cause it ain't gonna pay the bills, baby. It ain't gonna pay the bills. It ain't gonna pay the bills, baby. It ain't gonna pay the bills. She said.
This is the most beautiful thing you have ever seen. I know I should have waited, but once I saw her, I had to get in her, man. It was just chemistry. It was like a sex chemistry thing, you know?
Hi, I'm Christina.
That's Christina. Look, man, rear wheel drive, okay? Talking 12 fucking cylinders. This is Mark's current wife, Sylvia. Isn't she lovely?
Hi.
It's a pleasure to meet you.
Yeah.
Yes, baby.
Why don't you guys grab a drink? Me and a big fella had an exhilarating week. A lot of big news to share. So we're just going to talk about that a little bit, maybe dance a little bit, who knows. We're going to be inside. We'll see you guys inside.
Okay.
We'll be downstairs. All right.
Let's go.
Okay. I'm just going to leave. I like your dress.
Oh, thanks. It's new.
Oh, yeah.
What's that? Oh, I missed your toe.
Yeah, after I was driving back from the dealership, getting that sweet ride, I was thinking I should get something nice for the chica, you know? Spanish for girl. She's going really well, you know? Like, she's kind of lovely. I'm thinking get her like a fur, something nice for the winter. What do you think? Too much? Too early?
Yeah, I've seen Goodfellas, right? Specifically the pink Cadillac scene.
My shit. Love that movie, man. You fucking talking to me? You talking to me? You know? Yeah, it's good.
Each one is from a different place around the world.
You certainly have traveled a lot.
Yeah, and this is my favorite. It's the quetzal, which is a symbol of freedom in Guatemala. You know, this bird actually just dies of sadness if it's locked away in a cage.
It was good. Left the car in the parking lot, grabbed a bite to eat, came back to two of those beauties in the trunk.
Yeah. Did you see him at all? It was just kind of like,
out of sight, out of mind.
Exactly. Good shit, man. Pro shit, man. The next one's gonna be really good. You know, I got some ideas, thinking, just tinkering, you know? Just throwing some shit up on the wall.
I thought it was once and done.
Yeah, right, one and done. It's fucking money, dude. Come on. Nobody's gonna quit.
Or we could, because of Prudence.
Good song.
Yeah, Prudence.
The Prudence shit? Man, these fucking guys in Delaware, you wanna just let them down? They have expectations, you know? One thing I learned about those guys after that meeting, which was fucking creepy, by the way, there's two things they don't like. State taxes and being disappointed.
We keep going, the risks are only gonna get higher.
So is the fucking stacks of cash and candy. Fortune favors the brave. Like Instagram quotes and shit.
Fortune favors the smart. Quitting while you're ahead, now that's smart.
Nobody does that, that's like super old school.
Say prisons are full of nobodies.
Which is like a marriage thing. All you guys just get kind of snipped and you're all like this.
Like what?
Like, you know, the fucking killjoy that yanks the music off in the middle of the party. We're all fucking jamming and dancing like, hey, who's the asshole that pulled the plug? It's Mark. It's my friend Mark. You know, we're just getting started, you know? Come on, you and me, buddy. We're having a great time. Let's turn this around, huh? Up you go.
Grab a stick. Let's put some stuff in the hole. All right, I say one game, 10 grand. Let's go.
Five. Don't be a pussy. 20. Two balls in the hole.
For two balls in the hole?
I'm being brave. You wanted bravery, you got it.
You are being reckless. That's not confidence. That's why you need me by your side, my friend.
Ah, well, let's see about that. You know what? I'm just gonna stick with vodka. I don't need your little elixir. Thank you.
Would you like some?
Oh, I'm vegetarian, thanks.
I knew it. As soon as I saw you, I could tell. You've been a vegetarian for, like, a year?
About 6 months. How did you know?
I can just tell. It's in the skin. It gets like a greenish veggie hue.
What, like the living dead?
Oh, is that what I look like to you? To living dead?
Hey, don't worry. It's the right time to be a zombie.
You know what? He's right. It's like the fashion vanguard, you know? That's what everybody wants. That's what you're into.
How come every time the economy crashes, zombies turn up all over the place?
Hey, I need to go to the bathroom. Is it right there?
Yeah, it's just down the
hall.
We're
just kidding.
So sensitive, that one.
Wait, aren't you fucking vegetarian, too? You guys are so fun to hang out with.
You're learning Spanish, huh?
There she is. I learned some in the bedroom. I'll give you a book.
Hey. So we have some good news. We're trying to have a baby.
Wow.
Responsible news. Jesus.
What is?
Having a child is a crime against humanity, basically. I mean, there should be fucking laws against it.
Are you kidding?
At least until the world population gets down to like a reasonable level. Are
Shut
we not
up.
Clear on this?
What are you saying?
7 billion people and growing every minute is what I'm saying.
Are China, India, they're the ones who have the problem, not us.
Yeah, and they have a one kid per household rule already. It's not enough. Gotta be thinking radically about this, guys. There's not gonna be any fucking room left for us.
There's a lot of space out there, and it's mankind's destiny to conquer the stars.
Should you just say space?
That's cute. The attitude, I mean.
Well, I think it's great news. Congratulations.
It's a little early for that. Sylvia's not pregnant yet.
Oh, false alarm. Forget everything I said, guys. Cheers. Huh?
Hello. May I help you?
Hi, I'm sorry to intrude. My name's John. I'm your new neighbor. From what I gather, actually, your only neighbor for the time being, because I'm renting a house over by the lake. Oh. Just moved in this morning. Thought I would drop by, say hello.
Well, hello, John. I'm Sylvia, and welcome to our neighborhood.
Thank you. It's lovely to meet you. I'm not interrupting anything, am I?
Actually, we have friends over. We were just about to sit down and have dinner.
I'm away on business for a few days tomorrow, but maybe we could get together when I get back. Come over to the house, I'll cook you something. I'm not disastrous in the kitchen, it's okay. Excuse me, that's a Marchese you're wearing, isn't it?
It is, how did you know?
Well, I had an old girlfriend who used to love her designs. Mm. I bought her a dress from Marchese herself in Milan.
You did?
This is a guess. Do you work in fashion?
Oh, no, I just like to be fashionable.
Well, you look amazing. Not many women can wear a Marchese without looking ridiculous.
Thank you.
With compliments to my new neighbors.
So nice of you. You know what? I feel like I've been a bit rude. Why don't you just come in and meet my husband? Have a drink with us.
Okay. Just one.
Good.
And then I'll get out of your way, leave you to your friends, I promise.
Yeah. Come on in. This is John, our new neighbor. This is Mark, my husband.
A pleasure.
He's just going to join us for a drink.
Is he?
Just one, then I'll go. Sylvia did explain that you have company.
He's renting a house by the lake.
Yeah.
The Andersons?
No.
The Allens?
Harry and Paula.
Oh, we love them. They are so nice.
I didn't know they were renting.
I mean, they're always away.
Wow.
Yeah, it's big.
like a shipping container to meet that.
I don't want to stand on that.
I'll introduce you. Everyone, this is John. He's our new neighbor. And John, this is Sean and Christina.
Hi, Christina.
Hi.
Sean.
Have a seat.
Thank you.
John brought this as a gift.
Really? Wow. Just your regular standard issue $1,000 bottle of wine.
Yeah, it's a decent wine.
Well, I made a cocktail. Would you like one?
Oh, yes, thank you.
Sean, honey, will you hand me my back? Sean,
It's
right there. Thank you.
¿Eres española?
Sí.
¿De Madrid?
No, de Toledo.
¿Por poco?
Sí, muy cerquita. ¿Cómo lo sabes?
No creo que sea por mi color de piel.
Soy experto en acentos. Tu piel es perfecta, es luminosa.
Díselo a estos, no creo que piensen lo mismo.
An American from now on, please.
Yeah, I told you to learn Spanish, you lazy.
Okay, it's difficult.
Yeah.
So what, you were just walking your dog or something? You live in the neighborhood?
I don't have a dog, no. I was looking for someplace quiet to rent, and it's certainly that.
Do you like the town?
Well, I haven't had time to see much.
It's so hidden away, it's full of quiet spots. And it's a great place to raise kids. I mean, you can basically leave the doors open at night. It's like living in Canada.
Dear God.
Well, I don't have plans to have children right now.
Man after my own heart. I'm just talking about that. I like you, John. What do you do for a living?
I'm a consultant.
What about you, Sean?
What is it you do?
Me, I head finance over at Winfield Laboratories. Big pharma. You probably heard of us.
I know the company,
yeah,
absolutely.
Yeah.
And you, Sylvia, what do you do?
Well, I worked at the Guggenheim for 5 years, but now I'm on sabbatical. My year's almost ending. So I'm looking to start an art gallery. I'm seeking investors.
You must give me a call. What about you, Christina?
I studied marketing and advertising, and right now I'm with a master's in communication.
Well, I've always thought advertising fulfills expectations. People don't want the truth, they want hope.
Most people I know just want money.
Well, they want money to buy the things to bring them hope. And you, Mark, what line of work are you in?
I'm a chemist. Work with Sean, same firm.
Well, workmates and friends too. Interesting, I've never been one for making friends at work. But you must have an awful lot of interests in common.
Statistically, work is where you make the most friends.
Where did you say you consult?
Well, I've done my time at Deloitte, McKinsey, and the others. I went wherever the money was. I traveled a lot. Italy, Spain, Mexico, Costa Rica.
Oh, Costa Rica? I'd love to go to Costa Rica. Well, what's it like working in paradise?
Humid. You know, the idea of paradise is much better than the reality, let me tell you.
Imagination wins every time.
Exactly.
Wow, profound.
Yeah, I just got bored of working for other people, following orders. I want to set up my own business, be my own boss.
Good. My father always said it's better to be a big fish in a small pond than a small fish in a big one.
It's funny, my dad said the same thing too. And one day, a bigger fish swam by and gobbled him and his business up.
Yeah, well, both your dads are weird. I'd say the ocean is for the brave.
Big and dark. The perfect place for cowards to hide. You're a funny pair, you two. You don't seem at all alike. You've got nothing in common. In fact, I'd say you don't even particularly like each other that much. I mean, you don't have to pretend to be friends to be doing what you're doing. You can thieve and rob and not be pals.
Who are you?
I'm lost.
Yeah, me too.
Your nose is dripping. I'm curious, this cocktail, it's a Tom Collins, right? But at the same time, it's not a Tom Collins.
It's my Tom Collins, my version. I just changed an ingredient.
You gonna answer the fucking question?
Sean.
Sean what? Nobody else is fucking curious about this guy?
No, I give up. What is the mystery ingredient, then?
I use kiwi juice instead of lemon.
Kiwi juice. What a discovery.
What a discovery. Kiwi dreams.
Anybody gives a fuck? I asked you a question. What? Answer the fucking question.
Hey.
Please, sit down.
You're an asshole. Are you aware of that?
No, of course not. Assholes never are. All right, now I'm going to let you go, okay? Good.
Cell phone switched off. Placed on the table, please.
Mine is in the bedroom and it's switched off.
That's the truth.
I always tell the truth.
I have no intention of harming any of you. Unless you make me. I'm a professional. I don't do drama. Let's do this quickly, keep it nice and simple. Now, if you'd be so kind as to bring me the money that I've come for, I will leave right now, and you can carry on with your very pleasant evening.
The fuck are you talking about?
We don't keep money in the house.
Tonight, you do.
Can I smoke?
Oh, please.
Thanks.
There's no money.
Yes, what makes you think we have money?
Yeah, we have no idea what you're talking about.
Mark Dudek, 34 years old, married, no children. Although I think that's about to change. Lower middle class conservative family, two older sisters. Happy childhood, good student. Things got tough when your father lost his business, but you worked hard. You got yourself a scholarship, studied chemical engineering at Brown. You married well. Sportsman, football, climbing, diver. Started working at Winfield Laboratories 5 years ago, promoted director of special projects 2 years ago, and you haven't wasted a single moment since then. Mark, Sean Wells. 35 years old, single, parents divorced. One older brother. Difficult adolescence, boarding school at 14, graduated in economics from Stanford. Your first job, investment banking in the city. Winfield Laboratories hired you 3 years ago.
Very impressive. You can use Google, everybody.
What Google didn't tell me is that you two are both players. Two harmless, greedy, senior management players who think they're smarter than everyone else. What I would call a slam dunk.
Real fucking brave for a guy holding a gun.
I'm not holding a gun. You have an incredible head for figures, but you're kind of reckless. And I think Mark would agree with me on that one. Because it was your idea to rip off the company, wasn't it? That's what you're doing. You're stealing information from the company that pays your salary and selling it to the highest bidder. And today is payday, which is why I think there's money in the house, Sylvia.
What is he talking about?
I've no idea. I've no idea what the hell he's talking about.
Sylvia doesn't know. Well, this is awkward. Bit of a problem, Mark.
I'm going to the fucking camp.
You can do your line right here. We're all tolerant people. I don't think anyone really cares. I know I don't. All right, gentlemen. It's getting late. I know you'd all prefer me to leave so you can carry on with your evening. The money, please.
Told you, we do not have money in the house.
Who the fuck keeps money in the house? You got the wrong fucking story, you got the wrong address, you got the wrong son.
I don't know where you came up with this story. But Shani and I never screwed our company. We never stole any information. We never sold anything to anyone.
I'm gonna give you 3 minutes.
For what?
If the money isn't here in that time, then I'm going to cut off Sean's fingers one by one.
Fuck my fingers?
I am going to ask you this once. This money he's talking about, is it here somewhere? Is it in our house?
Honey, there is no money. I don't know what he's talking about. There's no money.
Right now, I know what you're wondering.
Are you fast enough to grab that knife off the table? Let's say you were. What would you do? Stab me in the heart? No, you wouldn't. You couldn't do that. You want to try your luck, buddy? You want to see who's quickest? No, you don't.
Would be a fair fight. I was closer to you.
That's right. It wouldn't be fair at all. Because I've killed before, and you haven't. On the other hand, it hasn't crossed Sean's mind to go for the knife. His eyes haven't left the watch. He's wondering if I'm for real. Am I really going to chop his fingers off one by one, or am I bluffing? We'll soon find out.
I have 4 credit cards. Sylvia, you have a couple, right? Sean, 5, 6? We pull them all together. We can drive down to an ATM and get out about $30,000 between all of us.
$30,000?
Yeah.
What about you, Christina? Do you carry any credit cards?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, one.
Right, so that would make it a bit more than 30,000. Could you make it 40?
Definitely, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
I am not a fucking tourist! And frankly, it offends me that you think I might be. You could at the very least have offered me a wire transfer. Oh, you're pulling my leg. You are 2 very selfish little boys with no consideration for these amazing women that you claim to love. If you had any respect at all, you wouldn't be putting them through this. And the money would be here right now. You're right-handed, aren't you?
What the fuck does that have to do with this?
Because I'm guessing you'd prefer me to start on your left. Don't say I'm not considerate. 60 seconds left. Tick, tock, tick, tock. Tick, tock, tick, tock. Oh dear. Put your left hand on the table.
Fuck you.
Put your left arm on the fucking table!
No!
Fuck!
Hey,
just chill. You're gonna sit there and watch your friend get his finger hacked off. What, you suddenly not best buddies after all?
What the fuck? Why is it even my... Fuck!
Okay.
Make a fucking deal, all right? I got 100K in a fund right now. What do you have?
I could get another 100K.
That's 200K. Oh. As soon as the bank opens, it's fucking yours and we're done. We're done.
I want my money now.
Tomorrow. It's the same thing. What's
Sylvia,
the difference?
Sylvia, I'm so sorry. I'm going to make a mess of your...
No, all right. Fuck, it's in the basement. Fuck, man.
It's where?
In the fucking basement of the pool table. Fuck!
Thank you.
Fuck. What the fuck?
Wasn't that hard. Christina, would you please go and get the money and bring it back here? And then we're done.
Where's the basement?
Oh, it's the door by the refrigerator.
You lied to me? I asked you if there was money in our house and you lied to me?
What did you want me to tell you?
The truth.
Can we not do this now, the fucking truth reality check? That everything isn't a fucking fantasy land in the real world, Sylvia, all right? There's no fucking Santa Claus, okay? Can we break that to you? There's no stork that feeds babies or fucking heaven on Earth.
All right. So everything that he has been saying, is it all true? Have you been stealing secrets from the company and selling them? When? Why not now? You put me and all of us in danger in our home! How could you?
Yeah, Mark. How could you?
Ah, here she is.
You two are a pair of jerks. Why the hell didn't you give them the money when he asked for it? Shit, he was gonna cut your fingers off.
Fucking sit down.
Sean. Don't be rude. Say you're sorry.
Sean.
You... Fuck, I'm sorry.
Very good. Was there another case in the basement?
No.
No.
You're sure?
Yeah.
Just the one?
Yes.
Well, where's the rest of the money?
That's all the fucking money!
No, no, this is half the money.
Your half, I'd say.
Which means the Mark share is still missing.
That's all there is. He's telling the truth. There's no more, I swear. It's all there is. You got $2.5 fucking million. Go.
Do you know, when I was in Mexico, I spent a good deal of time in the desert. The only company I had were the salamanders. Let me tell you about salamanders. Beautiful creatures. Amazing, really. If you cut off the tail of a salamander, or the legs, they grow back in a matter of weeks. And they can do that as often as they need to.
I'm not a fucking salamander, man. I don't grow back new fingers. I sure as hell can't make money show up that I don't have. I'm fucking stupid. Oh! Oh, wait a minute, wait a minute! He cut off my finger. He cut off my fucking finger. Oh. You fucking psychopath!
Your index finger. I just cut off your index finger, to be precise.
Here. There's some ice.
Where is it?
Put it on there.
Where is it?
It's a clean cut. Should be able to stitch it right back on. Now, if someone goes to get my missing money...
Excuse me.
I'll let you go to hospital and you can have it taken care of. Hello, someone, go to get my missing money, please.
I have a cigarette.
Why don't you give a cigarette to the bleeding guy as well?
I don't fucking smoke.
Anyway, I thought you'd given up. Mark. Mark?
Yeah. Yeah.
The money.
It's over.
You disappointed? Sean's blood isn't blue after all.
My hopes were never that high. I know what I'm playing at.
Good. Your skin is beautiful.
I know.
Good.
Do you think they know what you're doing?
No.
You don't?
No, I don't think they have a clue. The way it looks, you're the only one around here that knows what you're playing at.
What shall we do?
Alright, what are we waiting for? Let's get a bucket of cold water on this fucker and get some answers, huh?
Not throwing a bucket of water in here.
Sean, I want to go home.
Oh, why? Isn't it going so well?
Look, I don't know how the hell you're gonna take care of this, but whatever it is, I don't think you need me, do you, honey?
Sweetheart,
We all want to do shit. All right, I might want to swing by the hospital and get my fucking finger sewn back on, but something's come up. So why don't you sit the fuck down until we get this sorted out?
We need to call the cops.
And tell them that we sold trade secrets for millions of dollars, or that we have a hostage in the house.
He's right, they're not going to call the cops. They can't.
Somebody's awake. Let's get started.
Christina, that was very brave of you.
Yeah, that's coming from a guy who just waved a gun at a bunch of unarmed women. So let's get to it, shall we? How did you know about the money, John? Who else knows? Who do you work for? Start anywhere.
No one else knows. I work alone.
Can we skip the bullshit part? I'll save you a salamander story and just tell us how you knew about the fucking money.
The information's out there. It's in the air. It's in the wind. You just need to know how to grab it.
Ah, we're still doing the Dr. Seuss fucking routine. How about you speak some fucking English?
Sean. Let's be smart about this.
I'm not fucking waiting anymore. Let's figure this out. What do we know about you? We know somebody supplied you with information, right? Check. We know it's probably Winfield or Delaware, maybe. And thanks to all the lovely toys here. And we're gonna find out one way or the other. So how about you tell us the fucking truth?
My God, you sound like a broken record. My head is going to explode. Could someone please bring me some paracetamol?
Oh, you having a bad day?
Thank you, Sylvia.
We should get him a fucking massage, too. You guys are fucking...
Are you offering?
John, I'm gonna hit you again and again and again till I get to the fucking truth.
Of course you are. I don't think so.
Oh, why is that? Because we were helpless, what was it? Greedy middlemen. Managers, right? Except, what happened to that slam dunk? You're tied to a fucking chair, dipshit.
Nothing's changed. You're still harmless and greedy.
I couldn't help but notice I didn't get any medicine when I was bleeding in your fucking lawn. Are we so different, he and I?
Oh, that's adorable.
Figure this shit out.
Thank you.
How did you know... we wanted a baby.
Wanted? Why? Don't you want to anymore? Oh, Sylvia, you're an intelligent woman, you know. We spin our lives all over the place.
He hacked us. He hacked our communications. That's how he knows everything about us.
All the more reason to off this fucker right now.
Look, I acknowledge I've been arrogant. I have put us all in this awkward situation. It's my fault, but it's really not that difficult for us to resolve.
Us? The language has changed a bit, hasn't it? Are we all on the same team now? No, it's you and it's us. We're fucking enemies, but you know that, don't you?
Oh, enemies. You make it sound so dramatic.
Do I sound dramatic?
Yes.
Let's get dramatic. I mean, what are we waiting for? How about the fucking drone? Oh, want to be
Sean,
fucking dramatic?
Put the gun down.
How would be dramatic?
Put the gun down, Sean.
What are we waiting for with this piece of shit?
I want to hear what he has to say.
Why are we so interested in what he has to say? All right.
Calm down.
Take a seat. I apologize.
Now, John, what's your solution?
Finally, thank you. It's really very simple. You untie me, and I walk out that door with that case of money, and you never lay eyes on me again as long as you live. I promise.
That's an option.
I just want to get this clear, so I just don't want to make any mistakes. We untie you, give you $2.5 million. Is that enough? And then, do you want to ride to the bus station?
I'm actually being generous. I'm only taking half the money.
It's fair. What's the alternative? Do you give me your word that if we untie you, we give you half the money, you will disappear for the rest of our lives?
Mark, I can't fucking take this anymore. Shut her up or I will. You're fucking raving. What is happening
right now? You
are
the one
right
that
now?
Is raving, asshole. You're swinging a gun all over the place.
At least I'm fucking doing something. You want to fucking make a deal with him, you rich, delusional, fucking uppity, silver spoon bitch?
Whoa,
sit down.
Enough.
What?
Yes.
What are we doing?
Enough.
Were you not there?
Yes.
Outside?
Sylvia,
Yes. I give you my word.
That's worth a lot. That's worth a finger, probably, at least.
Sylvia, listen to me, all right? You trust me, right? Look, I'm taking care of this. I just need a minute to think.
Why don't you guys take five? Have your fucking powwow, have a hot tub, whatever it is. I'll get the interrogation started. I saw some great shit on you.
Look, can we just get everything out? Let's just get everything out. Look, we have no guarantee that you're gonna keep your word. Just 1 minute ago, outside, you were acting like a cruel, cold-hearted psychopath. And you know way too much about us. And that scares the shit out of me. So how do we know if we just let you go that you're just not gonna say anything, do anything?
There is only one way. I give you my word. And then you have to trust me.
How has this turned into a fucking negotiation? I said interrogate.
I don't think you're the most lucid guy in the room. In fact, you're paranoid. And every time you wander off to the bathroom, you come back in here even more paranoid. So how about you sit yourself down and leave the conversation to the adults?
Is this fucking paranoia? Right? That's paranoia, right? I don't have a fucking finger now. Mark, you want a guarantee? You want to rest yourself at ease? How about I fucking disappear this piece of shit off the face of the earth now? I don't even need to watch it.
Disappear me off the face of the earth? What, are you going to fly me into space?
I said I'm going to... The face of... That's not even... I don't fucking... Outer space, okay? We have...
How about I just bury you?
Bury me? No, well, that's more plausible. But there is still a problem. Someone will actually have to do it to kill me. Would that be you?
Yeah, I think it might be fucking me. Except I don't really have to kill you with my fucking bare hands. Or just throw
Except
you in the
that bar. You don't have the guts to kill anybody.
Sean!
What?
Stop it! Jeez! What the fuck are you doing? Come on, Sean.
Mark.
What?
Why? Our house is paid for. You make good money.
Why? I don't know why. Because you want to live in this perfect world where you're taken care of, and it doesn't matter what the costs are.
Me? You did it for me?
Yes! Yes, of course I did it for you!
Then give it back! Give it all back!
That's not how it works! I can't just give it back! I'd go to jail!
No, you... Okay, if I have this straight, you sold sensitive information to another pharmaceutical firm, am I right?
Correct! Industrial espionage!
So, you get a good lawyer, and then... You just give the money back, and then you tell them they can't use the information or you'll sue them. These Wall Street listed companies, they don't want a scandal. It'll
be
fine.
Oh my God, jeez, this is not the fucking lost and found. You don't give it
I'm
back.
I'm not talking to you.
You are talking to me. You're talking to him, you're talking to me. This goes south, I go to fucking jail, not you. Not you. That's our shit. It's my fucking money.
Sylvia, you are an admirable woman, but Mark's right about this. You can't just hand the money back.
I don't want to be involved in this.
I'm not giving the money back.
Okay, you made your decision. I am going to my parents. Fucking leave it.
The fuck you are? Sit down! Sylvia, get back here right now, I swear to God.
Or what?
Or what? You want to find out?
What do you want to do? Are you saying that I can't leave my own home?
Sean,
are you going to just tie me up? How are you going to keep me there? Are you going to put me in a chair?
Can I talk to you in private? Can I talk to you in private? In the kitchen?
Sean.
Mark, wait.
Sean!
Wait here for a fucking second.
Hey. What? There's only one way to end this one thing for all. You fucking get that, right? No, I don't get that. Oh, Jesus, man. We gotta fucking take him to a secluded area and kill him with his own gun. All right, don't worry about it. I'll handle it. I can do it. Sylvia and Christina don't even know shit. All right, we just fucking tell him. We're gonna let him go. We're gonna drive him somewhere far off so it's like a precaution or something to keep them safe, okay? And we don't need to talk about it. It's done. Easy peasy.
You're being serious. You're really being serious with all this?
Yeah, I'm being fucking serious. You wanna die? You want him to fucking kill us? Figure out some way? You wanna go to jail? I wanna live. Alright, we gotta get our hands a little fucking dirty.
Our hands are already dirty. Look, I think he's telling the truth. I think he works alone. Let me just negotiate.
We already tried that, man. He didn't bring this fucking gun to negotiate with us, okay? He knew it from the fucking start.
Probably fucking connected to Delaware or something, all right? We asked them for a wire transfer. Do you remember that? And they insisted on cash. It was a fucking setup, dude. They paid us in cash so they could rob us in cash.
Do you know the best thing about being young? It's not being paralyzed by the fear of consequences. But it can also get us into trouble. What are you planning on doing with that money? What, you thought no one was gonna notice? I suppose it was an impulse. So far, neither Sean nor Mark has looked inside that case. But eventually they will do. And then I'm afraid you're scuppered.
Don't know what you're talking about.
Christina, Sean's not gonna be happy when he finds out his girlfriend has been stealing money from him. And from the brief time I've spent with Sean, I'd say he's probably gonna get violent.
If we offer him $1 million, take it or leave it, he'll take it. And then we just let him go. It's not gonna fucking work, dude. Look how easily he fucking got to us. He's in your house. You wanna give him $1 million so he can walk away? You think he won't fucking come back? Think it'll be pretty?
That's a risk we gotta take.
That's a risk I will never take. Sean. That's my fucking money.
And there's plenty more where that came from.
There's not any more. He shut the fucking door.
We'll
all right?
Open another one, okay?
No fucking way. Can't take a fucking piss without him knowing what I had for breakfast. Mark, man.
I like you. I like your spirit. You're brave. You've earned it. Boldness deserves its reward. Think about it. If I win, you win too. But if I lose, well then so do you.
This is the only time I've ever seen that much money in fucking cash. The only day of our lives that we have millions of dollars in cash laying out, and what do? You walk some dude through your front door to fucking steal it? Really? Your wife wants to cure his fucking headaches. You want to make sure I don't kill him. I'm the only one that gets fucking hurt here.
You done?
No. I think you guys are fucking working together. Oh.
Knock it off, Sean.
How do I know, man? I thought we were friends, buddy. I thought you and I were a team.
We are friends.
Show me. Show me.
Christina here was just telling me about all the admirable qualities she sees in you.
You sound like a broken record, mate. You act so sophisticated and smart and handsome, but you're a fucking fraud. You're just a guy with a gun who lost his advantage and quite a great deal of money to the girl with pepper spray in her purse. That is not gonna look good on a resume.
I'm your husband. I need you with me on this tonight more than ever. You know why? Because I love you.
I would never have put you in a situation like this. I have to go.
You know your problem is? You live in a glass bubble. You have no idea how much it costs to maintain this lifestyle of ours. I was doing it for my family, for our future.
Stealing is how you take care of a family.
All right, you're right. You're right. I'm sorry. Here's of the truth. The whole truth. We've been living beyond our means for a long time now. And the time has come to pay the bills. Or to take everything away from us.
What are you talking about?
We're in debt. And I use the house as collateral because I need the money to keep on investing and make up for my losses. We aren't just in debt.
used the house as collateral.
Can't say this wasn't an exciting date, you know? I think we'll look back on this adventure years from now and just laugh.
Adventure? God, you're a fucking lunatic.
Oh, please, would you relax, okay? Just trying to lighten the mood. You don't have to be intimidated by him anymore, okay? He's tied up like a fucking turkey. I'm not going anywhere.
Calling a cab, I'm going home.
Oh, you're calling anymore. Put your fucking phone down. Talking about you calling a cab. We're kind of in the middle of something here.
Give me my phone.
I'm not giving you the phone, obviously.
Or giving me my
phone. Forget about the fucking phone!
Oh, wow. Jesus. Wow, smooth.
Shut the fuck up. You will have my undivided attention in a moment. Hold on a second.
I'm walking.
You're not going anywhere. What are you doing right now? It's a phone. I'll buy you another one. It's a
so
fucking least important...
So you can smash it against me.
I'm not going to smash your phone again, okay? I'm sorry. I'm a little fucking stressed out, all right? I don't know where my head was.
Hey, you know what your problem is? You don't know where your head is at least once or twice a day.
Yeah, well, somebody just tried to steal everything I fucking have and cut off my finger. You think
that
my...
we should be at a hospital, but you don't want to go. And I just want to go home. It's not so fucking hard to understand.
Will you lower your fucking voice?
I'm not going to tell anything. I want to get home and crawl into my bed, okay?
You're right, okay? I'm sorry. I was gonna tell you before I let him go, okay? I talked to Mark. I worked it out. He's gonna give him half of his share. I'm gonna drive him somewhere far away. Let him go, because if he's far away, I feel safe about you being safe. That's what's important to me, okay? You're not safe here right now. Let me work on this. I'll figure it out, okay? You're doing really good. Don't fucking lose it on me now.
Be quick.
Be quick. I'm gonna grab a fucking drink.
Oh, sure. Mine's a Tom Collins with extra kiwi juice.
Will you stop provoking him? God, I thought you were smart.
I'm sorry, I can't help myself. It's just too much fun. Christina, you know he's not gonna let you go anywhere, don't you? You know what's gonna happen. Sean's made up his mind that he's gonna kill me, and the really sad thing is he thinks he can, because he's watched too many bad movies. So he'll probably drive me out into the woods somewhere, put a gun to the back of my head, but it is my gun. And only one of us is gonna end up dead, and I assure you it will not be me. The only chance Sean has is if you untie me right now. Sean lives, and you get your money.
Mi padre siempre dice que quien no arriesga no gana.
Me gusta tu padre.
Listen, no one is gonna get hurt. The money, you get the fuck out of here, okay?
And no one will ever know. Christina, the knife on the case.
Christina? I think some of that pepper spray got into my eyes. You know, it's fucking stinging. Could you run to my car? And, in my glove box, I got some eye drops.
The key?
You don't need them. It is open. You don't need this. You're coming back, yeah? Yeah. Exactly. Oh, finally. Huh?
Where's my drink?
You weren't meant to find out. It's supposed to be temporary. That's why we need the money.
I'll ask my dad for the money.
Your dad can't help. lost 10 times what I did. When we started losing, he said we had to hold strong. It was the only way we'd earn back the money that we lost. That's what he said. That whoever held in the longest would end up earning the fortune. But he was wrong. Ruined all of us.
You're lying.
I wish I was.
Earlier you said you did all this for me. That's the lousiest thing you've ever said in your life. You're a coward. Have you decided what to do with John?
My plan is to negotiate with him. See if he'll settle for $1 million and let him go.
You think he'll leave us alone?
I hope so.
It really makes no sense to let him go with the money.
Just a minute ago, you were fine with him leaving with half the money.
A minute ago, I didn't know we were bankrupt. What about Sean? He's a problem.
Let me handle Sean.
He said a lot of interesting things tonight. A lot of them are true, actually. Asshole. That's me. Greedy, even. It's true, but don't know about harmless!
Harmless really touched a nerve. That was for the finger, you may gather.
Fair enough. So technically I owed you. If memory serves, you were right-handed, correct? So I'm not gonna be quite as kind as you were. Let's just go ahead and lose a couple digits, shall we? Oh!
What's going on? What'd you do with Sean?
Sit down. Over there. Sit down. Take a seat. You too. Please.
Sean. Sean. Come on. He's coming with me.
Where are you taking him?
Relax, I'm only gonna lock him up. Vamos.
What happened? How did he get untied? How did he get untied? Who tied him up in the first place?
He's high. He must not have done the best of jobs.
We never should have left Sean alone with him. What do we do?
There's not many options left.
Where's your share of the money?
In the safe.
Okay, we need to buy time.
What good will that do? We had our chance. Sean screwed it for all of us.
No, forget about Sean. Focus on the money.
Oh, now you're worried about the money?
Screw the money. I just want him out of my house.
No, if you let him leave with the money, it's not going to be your house anymore. You can't let him go.
What would you like me to do then?
Buy us time. Got it.
Okay, Mark. Now it's your turn. Let's go find some money.
After you.
combination.
7-05-38.
What did you do?
Delayed opening security system. Won't open again for another 8 hours.
Now you're really fucking making me mad.
So, Mark, I hear you're a scuba diver. Well, let's see what you're made of! You're wasting your breath. Start focusing on what really matters, for once. Dying for money, grab you now.
You killed all of us.
No, Sean pissed me off. That got personal. So, are you gonna open this safe for me?
I can't. Once it's blocked, there's nothing to do except wait.
I believe you. But now you have a choice to make. It's very simple. Your money or your life.
You can have the money. You can have all of it. Safe still won't open for another 8 hours.
8 hours. I am not a patient man, Mark. Get out. Get out.
Get in there.
Well, it looks as if we have some time to kill.
Where's Sean?
Oh, don't worry. He's fine. They both are.
Great title.
It's a great book.
My favorite Bellow's always been Humboldt's Gift.
You like Saul Bellow?
He's okay.
He's not just okay, he's one of the greats.
Well, that's a matter of opinion.
No, that's fact.
So you're right and I'm wrong.
Yes.
But, I'm the guy with the gun.
Literature just isn't a question of taste, it's a question of talent.
Wow. Please. Go on.
Well, the world needs great literature. People who read great literature become wise, and wise men make good men.
Pretty difficult to become wise, though, if you don't understand what you're reading. I bet you'd make a great nurse.
I'm afraid your husband has rather complicated things. He's activated some security mechanism on the safe. It won't open for another 8 hours.
Well, that was reckless of him.
Futile gesture, I assure you. You don't happen to know how to unblock it, do you?
No, I don't even know the combination. Really, Mark is paranoid. He changes it every week. I'm not going to learn a bunch of new numbers every week.
No, I guess not. What time does the help get here?
The maid comes at 9.
And the gardener?
He doesn't work tomorrow.
No, he comes on Friday.
Right.
Right. Do you really never lie? But everyone tells lies. Life would be impossible without lies.
It would be fairer.
I'm crueler.
I think you need stitches.
I think so too.
Could easily get infected.
Just clean it, patch it up, it'll be all right for now.
All right. This is gonna hurt.
You're a very special woman.
You don't really know me.
You're well educated, intelligent, elegant. But any fool could see that. Your favorite writer isn't Bellow, it's F. Scott Fitzgerald. Your passion is art. Your favorite painters are Pollock, Gauguin, and El Greco. You have high hopes for your art gallery. You like the beach, but not the sea. Your favorite food is sushi. You don't scare easily, and you're gonna hate me for this one, but you're a little arrogant.
It's not arrogance, it's self-confidence.
I'll buy that. You love children. You're going to be a wonderful mother. I'm not so sure about Mark. Why is it you haven't told him yet?
I was saving it for his birthday. It was going to be a surprise.
But things just changed.
Yes, things just changed. What are you really like?
You mean apart from being a badass?
I don't know. You seem like maybe you could have talent. Why do you do this with your life?
Why not?
Well, because it isn't right.
stealing from thieves isn't right.
That's what you do, you steal from thieves.
Why didn't you ever ask me if Martin's okay?
Well, I know he's okay. He has to open the safe, and you're going to wait for the safe to open, right?
Well, I could always go and get the dynamite to keep in the trunk of my car and blow it to Kingdom Come.
You aren't the dynamite type. I think you're showing off.
Oh.
So you are gonna wait. $2.5 million. This is the jackpot.
No. $5 million. That's the jackpot.
Somebody there!
God, help me, I'm locked down here. Hello? I'm down here in the basement.
Mr. Dudek, what are you doing down here?
Please. There's a thief in the house. He's gonna come back.
Is he still here?
Yes, yes. We need your help. He locked down here in the basement. Please. You gotta go free, Sylvia.
Where is she?
I'm gonna go and get Mark.
He's coming. Okay, Carl, hurry.
Morning. Come with me. I said come on.
No.
Excuse me?
I said no.
You gotta be kidding me. I thought we'd been through all this before. I'm beginning to lose patience with you. Do you want to make me bring out my gun again? You don't get out of there right now, I'm gonna kneecap you. First your right knee, then your left.
Carl.
Shh. Your husband told me about the thief.
You talked to Mark?
Yeah, he's in the basement. You got you all tied up. What? You want me to go get the cops?
No cops.
No cops? Why no cops?
Carl, I need you to trust me.
3 seconds. Good boy.
Come on. That's a good chap.
It's okay. Are you all right?
Yeah, I'm okay. You
got one chance. The safe opens first time or I blow your brains out. Open the case. Put the money in the case. The money in. Close it. Sit down.
And Sean? Mark.
Hands. 6'2", blonde hair, cropped short, military style, Eastern European accent. Weighs about 220 pounds. Dressed casual, blue jeans, dark sweatshirt, sneakers. Scar above his right cheek. That is the description that you will give the police. Are you happy with that, Mark?
Yes.
Good. I'm really very sorry. This should have been much simpler. Walk in, grab the money, walk right back out. I'm normally very good at my job. The help will be here shortly. They will untie you. Sylvia, Christina, I wish you the very best of luck with the rest of your lives.
Where's Sean? You fucking liar.
You're welcome. It's been a pleasure.
Mark Dudak, correct?
Correct.
And your description of the assailant?
6'2", 220 pounds, blonde cropped hair, army style.
He had an Eastern European accent, dressed casual, blue jeans, dark sweatshirt, sneakers, scar above his right eye.
And he had a scar right above his right cheek.
His right cheek? Or his left cheek?
Right cheek.
is right, Chief.
Yes. Excuse me. I really need to get out of here. I have to go home. Can I call a cab?
No problem. I can have one of my officers accompany you.
Thank you so much.
Yes, sir. Please.
Thank you so much.
I'm leaving. I'll send someone to pick up the rest of my things in a few days.
What are you talking about?
I just got out of the glass bubble. I'm divorcing you.
What's this?
A gift.
Trying to buy me off?
No, I want...
You don't have to explain anything to me. And you don't have to buy me off. You're safe.
I'm sorry. I didn't want to offend you.
No.
I want you to have this. You deserve it. You helped me.
No, I didn't.
Yeah, you did.
No. Thursdays are my day off. I wasn't even in the house. I don't know what happened there. And I don't want to know.
Will you please take it as like a present? A parting gift?
What, are you leaving?
Yeah. I think this is the first time I've ever seen you smile.
Yeah. I guess it makes me smile to say no to that wad of cash and feel so happy about it.
You're sure?
Yeah. I could get used to it.
All right. Thanks for showing me your moves.
That was my pleasure. You be well.
You too.